introduce him. I call upon Master Shubham Chandel to introduce Most Reverend Dr. Albert D'Souza.
D'Souza was born in Mangalore on 4th August 1945, one of 13 children of Mr. Emmanuel D'Souza and Mrs. Cardoza. He got his primary and secondary education at St. Lawrence High School and his BA degree from Kumar University, Nainital. Being brought up in a pious Christian family, he developed great love for the church and felt a calling to join priesthood. In 1965, he joined St. Paul's Minor Seminary at Dilkut, Lucknow, and pursued his studies for priesthood at Lucknow and Allahabad. He was ordained priest at St. Joseph's Cathedral, Lucknow, on 8th December 1974. He was sent to Rome from 1984 to 88 to do doctorate studies at Pontifical University, San Tommaso Angelicum, and obtained his doctorate in spiritual theology. On his return to the diocese, he served at St. Paul's Minor Seminary for a year and later was sent to St. Joseph's Regional Seminary at Allahabad as Professor of Theology and Spiritual Director from 1989 to 92. After the transfer of Bishop Alan de Laste to Delhi as Archbishop in 1991, the See of Lucknow fell vacant. His Holiness Pope John Paul II elected Father Albert as successor to the See of Lucknow on November 26, 1992. His episcopal consecration took place at St. Joseph's Cathedral, Lucknow, on 7th February, 1993. And he was installed as the 4th Bishop of Lucknow. He was installed as the 10th Archbishop of Agra on 11th April, 2007, at the Cathedral of Immaculate Conception, Agra. We once again welcome you and invite you to come to the stage and address all of us.
Mr. Principal, Father John Pereira, Vice Principal, Father Prakash, Sister Bridges, Headmistress and members of the staff, dear children, my dear parents, at the outset, I would congratulate the performers. It has been a wholesome, perfect performance along with the academic activities. It is not so easy to develop the individual talents of music and other social habits. St. Peter's not just ascends the ladder of success, but I gather moves along unceasingly in a wider horizon of excellence. And I congratulate the teaching staff, the parents, and my dear children. May your ladder of excellence be raised higher beyond the boundaries visible. As you said, your achievement is unbelievable. The positive approach to life that you have depicted, Papa, Bechara Papa, was shown with a positive note. One does not give up. UNESCO has explained modern education on four pillars: learning to know, and learning to do, learning to relate to people around and to the world at large, learning to be. I observe St. Peter's not just learning to know and to do, learns also to relate to the wider world, and in fact learns to be. Building up just personality remains work half done. It is the development of the whole human person, integrating body, mind, spirit harmony. Addition that has come forth in this campus in the recent years has been all-round growth of a child, taking into account the value of the spiritual. The body and the mind are fused together with the development of the spiritual faculty. Yoga is one of such means, handy and easily available. Apart from that, the sense of the spiritual will probably bind humanity together into one family. My appreciations, therefore, the excellence that St. Peter's is striving at is not just what is to be strived, but what is even achieved year after year. My prayer to God is St. Peter's may preserve the sanctity of the campus of moral, ethical, religious, and in fact, basic human values of respecting every living creature equally. My compliments to the parents who are fostering these values to make a contribution to a wider society, that our Indian society may truly be an exemplary human society, that we have something to offer to humanity and to the world. God bless and congratulations, dear boys.
With a difference. Our students on wheels, that is, the chorus skating team, will present a demo to the tune of the final countdown. So ladies and gentlemen, here comes the Wheeler Dealers, who have mastered the art of balancing, coordination and symmetry. A big round of applause for these.